Well, hello there. Microsoft Project for the Web provides you the ability to quickly apply filters to a project to find information about what's happening on the project. Filters are applied at the project level and help you quickly target a variety of information, including the timing of the task, the status of it, which bucket each falls into, and who's assigned to it. You can also quickly filter on words that are in the task name simply by typing into the search box at the top. Before we look at Project for the Web, it's important to note that over in Project for the Web's big brother, Microsoft Project Online and Microsoft Project Professional, you can create many different types of filters: grouping, sorting, saved views, projects, tasks, resources, and so much more. See, here's where you find some of the filtering in Microsoft Project Professional using some predefined filters. You can also define your own filters and save those for the future. If you're watching on YouTube, please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to get notifications about new content like this. If you're watching on LinkedIn, please like, comment, or share. Okay, let's have a look at filters in Project for the Web. Here we are inside a web browser with Microsoft Project for the Web, and we've got a simple plan going here. Here in the right-hand corner, we find the filter menu. On the filter menu, we can type a keyword in the search box to find tasks that have that text in them. We can quickly search for work that is late, relative to the finish date, using the late filter, or similarly look for work that should finish today, tomorrow, this week, and so on. By clicking on a resource name, you can filter on tasks assigned to that particular resource. You'll note here that we've applied two filters at the same time, late and assigned to Dave. Other filters you can apply include looking for progress, things that are not started, in progress, or completed. You can also filter by the buckets you've defined in Project for the Web. Filters are available in each of the three views in Project for the Web: the grid, the boards, and the timeline. Filters applied in one view stay in effect for other views. Over in the timeline view, you get the ability to apply a filter for critical tasks. This isn't really a filter, but is actually a highlight of the critical path, including critical tasks and relationships. Finally, filters will stick with you from session to session. If you apply filters in your Project for the Web project and then get out of it and go back to it, the filters will still be applied, but they'll only be applied for you and not for another user. We hope this has been helpful for you. If you have any questions about using filters in Project for the Web or in Microsoft Project Online, please leave those in the comments below.
Western Principles is a Microsoft Gold Project and Portfolio Management Partner and a UMT 360 Gold Partner. We know Microsoft Project, Project for the Web, and Azure DevOps, and can help you with all aspects of your project and portfolio management. We can also help you extend your PPM system with the Microsoft Power Platform or partner solutions like the Strategy Hub and Portfolio Manager from UMP 360 to help you drive more ROI from your project and portfolio management system. Let's get started together. Visit us on the web, call us at 1-800-578-4155, or email us at info@westernprinciples.com. We look forward to helping you.